Good morning. My name is the Reverend Paul Lavender. I'm the senior pastor here in Mount Pleasant Baptist Church. Welcome to our morning service. It's really good to welcome you. And we're delighted that virtually, later in our time of worship, we have Pastor Benjamin Francis, who's the BMS Regional Director for Asia and also the Director of Big Life Ministries, a church planting and evangelism organization. He's going to be speaking to us from God's word. It's a real privilege for us to be able to hear from him and to share something of his work, his understanding of how God is leading, and also to share with us a little bit about how BMS are continuing to work during this time of global pandemic. So welcome to worship. We're going to be enjoying some songs which we can sing along to. We're going to be praying, and we're going to be interceding for our world. But before we do anything else, let's commit and commend our time to the Lord now in prayer. Let us all pray. O Lord our God, you know who we are, men and women with good consciences and with bad, persons who are content and those who are discontent, the certain and the uncertain, Christians by conviction and Christians by convention, those who believe, those who half believe, those who disbelieve. And you know where we have come from the circle of relatives, acquaintances and friends, or from the greatest loneliness, from a life of quiet prosperity, or from manifold confusion and distress, from family relationships that are well ordered, or from those disordered or undistressed, from the inner circle of the Christian community, or from its outer edge. But now we all stand before you in all our differences, yet alike in that we are all in the wrong with you, and one day we must die, that we'd all be lost without your grace, but also in that your grace is promised and made available to us all in your dear Son, Jesus Christ. We are here together in order to praise you through letting you speak to us. We beseech you to grant that this may take place in this hour. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, we pray. Amen.
To the darkness created the light. He is the heart.
So let's continue to give thanks and praise the Lord our God in prayer. Let us pray. We read in Revelation 4, "You are worthy, O Lord our God, to receive glory and honour and power, for you created all things, and by your will they existed and were created. You are worthy, O Christ, for you were slain, and by your blood you ransomed us for God. From every tribe and tongue and people and nation, you've made us a kingdom of priests to serve our God. So to him who sits upon the throne and to the Lamb, be blessing and honour and glory and might for ever and ever. Amen." So Lord, we thank you this morning for your greatness and for your power, for our salvation, and for the knowledge that Jesus is with us in every situation. Thank you for that heritage of faith that's been passed on to us. And this morning especially, we come to thank you for the vision of apostles and evangelists who brought it to us, gracious Lord. For the courage of martyrs and teachers who secured it for us. For the devotion of preachers and pastors who proclaimed it to us. For the love of families and friends who nourished it within us. For the freedom to speak of it in the world around us and to share it with our neighbours. Lord, we thank you and we praise you for this heritage of faith and pray for the will and for the strength to pass it on to others for the glory of your name through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So let's share together, shall we, in saying the Lord's Prayer, in whatever language or form is common for us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Amen.
Blessed be your name. Thank you.
greetings to all my brothers and sisters listening to me right now. My name is Benjamin Francis. I am the team leader for BMS in India. It is so good to speak to you today. You know, somebody has said this wonderfully. If you want to be discouraged, look back. If you want to be disturbed, look around. If you want to be dismayed, look ahead. But if you want to be delivered, look up. Because the Lord is reaching out to you and me, especially through His Word. So could we just open our Bibles and look into Isaiah 43 verses 1 and 2 with me. But now thus says the Lord, who created you, O Jacob, that He who formed you, O Israel, fear not, I have redeemed you, I have called you by your name, you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, nor shall the flame scorch you. You see, these promises that the Lord had given to us. I'm saying to us because see the people that God is addressing to. This is happening 700 years before Christ's birth. And the people that He is addressing to is wonderfully mentioned in the first verse. The last three words of the verse 1 says, you are mine. Wherever you are, can you say that with me? I am the Lord's. And I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why. Because the scripture says that we are His by creation in verse 1. He who created you. That means you and I are God's property. Because He made us. Colossians 1:16. You go back to Genesis chapter 1 verses 16. We see how He made us. Secondly, we are His by redemption. I have redeemed you, the Lord says. You see in 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 18 or 1 Corinthians chapter 6 verses 19 and 20 where the Lord redeemed you and He redeemed me. Thirdly, we are His because of election. You see, I have called you by name. He knows our name. He knows our name. He said, I called you by name. John chapter 15 verse 16, that He is calling us by name. So we are His by election. So by creation, redemption, and election. And then He says in verse 1, He says, fear not. Did you know that in the Bible, fear not is mentioned over 366 times? We all know that we have 365 days in a year. But there's one extra, even for a leap year, so that every morning you could get up, look into the mirror, take your name and say, Benjamin, fear not. Benjamin, fear not. No matter what is happening in the world, fear not. Not only that He's telling us not to fear, but He is also telling us that we as His elected ones, we as His redeemed ones, we as His created ones will not have it easy. He knows our pathway, and most of you must be in great difficulties as you live out of your home. For me to be in my house, it's crazy. Because I am always on the field. For some, most of you who have an idea of what I do, I'm always on the ground. So being indoors is difficult. But in all of this, the Lord is also telling us, for all the people who are having a very, very tough time, I am talking to you from India, where people don't know where their next meal is going to come from. We have people who are dying out of starvation. We have news moms who are throwing her kids into the river. She had 5 kids, she threw them into the river because she cannot feed them. We have people in some of our areas where they are cutting down leaves and boiling it and giving to their children when they are crying out for food. To add to our problems with the COVID-19, we were just hit by cyclone Amphan, and it has taken off huge areas. People have lost their homes. People have lost all the irrigation equipment. They have lost their fields where they had sowed. Everything is gone. Yes, the testing might be tough. The pathway is not going to be easy. It is really disturbing and maybe very discouraging if we had to stop it here. But verse 2 does not end here. But before I come to verse 2, I just want to ask you to take a few moments and look at the video, what BMS and Big Life is doing across India, in Bangladesh, Nepal, how we are really making a difference even while we are on this pathway, because you are helping in making this difference.
The world is united by an enemy. A virus that is stealing lives and spreading fear. For years to come, we will be remembered for how we responded. For staying home and protecting our communities. And also for loving our global neighbours. We will be remembered for praying, for giving, to help them respond. In Afghanistan, Nepal, Mozambique, Sri Lanka, Chad, Albania, and across the globe, for feeding the hungry, for counselling the sick, for providing protective equipment on the front lines, for helping to stop the spread. Remembered for being united, together. Remembered for standing in solidarity. The world is hurting, and we can help. BMS World Mission is responding to the coronavirus pandemic. We're helping to coordinate the global Baptist response, and we're doing it now, in the name of Jesus. You can be a part of it. You can stand in solidarity with people around the world fighting coronavirus and feeling its effects. You can look back on this time and know that you did everything in your power to help. You can respond today.
Let's get back and finish what we have been looking just before the video. The promises of God. Otherwise, what I've said before could be very depressing. If the pathway is so difficult, the testing is so severe, what are we about to do? Or what do we trust in? We have the promises of God, and He never breaks His word. We can compare His promises in Numbers chapter 23, 19, Deuteronomy 7, 9. You can come to New Testament, Titus 1, 2, Hebrews 6, 18. But here, He's making a few promises to you and me in this difficult, difficult time that you might be going through. Firstly, He promises the security of His property. He has already mentioned that in verse 1. You are mine because of creation, because of redemption, because of election. I'm not going to let you go. It has costed him everything to redeem you and me and make us his own. He's adopted us in his family. Who can take us away from him? Because our names are written on the palm of his hand. We are the apple of his eye. Nothing can separate us from the love of God. Secondly, we see here his promises are that he will give his presence to us consistently during this time. So he promises the consistency of his presence in your life and in my life. And that's why the word says, when all these things happen, that means I will be with you. When you're going through the waters, through the flames, Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego were in the fire and somebody saw four of them were there. He's saying, behold, we see the fourth man and he is looking like the Son of God. I don't know where you need him. You need the third man or the fourth man, or you are all alone in your home today. His promise is that he is going to be with you. He will be with us. And lastly, we see he promises the fulfillment of his purposes. During this time, God has a purpose. God has a purpose for your life and mine. I never thought about this, but when I started off with COVID-19, I now see what God is doing. That's why when I read this, God has a purpose in everything. In Romans 8:28, that his people are always fulfilling his purpose. Even though sometimes we think we are torn apart, we've been destroyed, we are devastated. We don't know what's going to happen. But he is fulfilling his purpose through you, through me. In this time of COVID-19, during us making a plan of going out to give out food to people, whether it was on the streets doing hot meals or we getting into communities so that we can help them, because they are daily wage workers. They don't know where their next income is going to come from, how they are going to feed their children, what are they going to do the next day. And when we went there with the food, we were amazed that God was actually opening doors for us to give them eternal food. And suddenly, after all of these were happening with thousands of families that we were reaching out into the remotest parts of Sundarbans, remotest parts of Orissa, remotest parts of Jharkhand and Nepal and places like that, we started seeing something else happening. We started seeing people open for prayer because they were so caught up with fear, because that's the greatest virus which has gripped the people, fear. Fear cancels faith. But what we were doing there, we were showing them God's love. We were allowing them to touch love. And we were allowing them to hear about hope. Faith cancels fear. And we have seen so many people believing, so many miracles on the ground. We've seen so many open doors. Just last week, I heard that in one area, 20 new places have opened up where we are starting fellowships. People are healed of 30 years of diseases. And he's going out and telling people that COVID-19 has just come around. Jesus is able to heal what I was suffering for the last 30 years. With the blood coming out of my skin, it was breaking down, and God's people started praying. Most of our work is going on steroids at this point, because people are being able to meet every day because they have nowhere else to go. So they're taking out the word. They're going to doing, they're getting together and doing 3/3. They're discussing God's word. Many families that did not know the word, did not know the power of the word, is being able to see that. And many people are coming to the Lord. Many people are being baptized. And in one of those areas, we have somebody who wanted to be baptized, but there was no water. So they were praying, and that night there was thunderstorm and rain, and they gathered water in a plastic tub and baptized people. So it's just amazing. I had no clue that this was going to happen, but God is saying that he promises the fulfillment of his purpose. There is a purpose for you. There's a purpose on your street waiting. There's a divine appointment for you, my brothers and sisters. There are people that you have not spoken to, but this is the time to speak to them, because God has given you the word of hope, the word of love, the word of peace, the word of joy. This is your opportunity to let people around you in your neighborhood touch love. The world has, we know it has changed, but the promises of God never change. So God bless you, and may God use you for His glory. Amen.
Good morning, Church. Today we are praying for the World Health Organization. It was founded in 1948 for the following work: to promote development and overall health in areas of poverty, to take steps to reduce health risks from outbreaks of new, existing and mutating diseases, to strengthen health systems in poorer countries, to conduct research, develop strategies and measure results, to encourage partnerships to implement health programs. The The Lord Jesus went about doing good works and healing sickness and infirmity of every kind. And he commanded his disciples to care for the sick, to pray for them, and to lay hands on them. Jesus attended to everyone who were outcast because of their infirmities, healing people whose illnesses resulted from their poverty and lack of resources. He ignored no one who came to him. Merciful God, hear our fervent prayer for all who suffer from disease throughout the world, especially those who live in developing nations. May those who suffer receive the proper treatment and the comfort of your healing presence. May the doctors, nurses, families, and neighbours be protected from COVID-19. Protect and guide those who strive to find cures, that their work may restore communities to wholeness and health. Guide and encourage global partners to work together to improve health delivery systems. Give solace to those who grieve the loss of loved ones and bring hope to survivors. We ask this through the name of your Son, the Lord Jesus. Amen.
So we thank Benjamin for what he shared with us today and pray that we may have that confidence in God's presence with us each day of our lives as we go out into the week ahead. God bless you and keep you, and may you continue to know the fellowship, praying with and for you and surrounding you with love in all you say and do. So let me bless you as we conclude our worship. Go now in the peace and strength of God, ready to impart to others what you have first received from him. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you and with those whom you love, and with God's people everywhere, this day and forevermore. Amen.